Nikki Haley, the governor of South Carolina, is a very serious politician. Jennifer Wishon, or Jenny in the B block, had a chance to catch up with Governor Nikki Haley in Washington, D.C. Jennifer.
Thanks, David. Nikki Haley is serious indeed. She was just elected governor 15 months ago and has already written a biography. It's getting her national attention just as the GOP is getting close to picking its nominee, who will soon need a running mate. Seriously, though, Haley has a true American success story that's worth reading about.
Nikki Randhawa Haley was born to Indian immigrants in the small town of Bamberg, South Carolina, a place where things were black and white, down to the people. For a girl with brown skin and a Sikh father, life in Bamberg wasn't always easy.
We were the only Indian family in the small town of Bamberg, South Carolina. My dad wore a turban and my mom wore a sari, and Bamberg had never seen anything like that. So we survived. We survived the only way we knew how, and we stayed close and we stayed committed to each other.
Young Nikki faced her share of discrimination. She was even disqualified from a beauty pageant because, get this, the judges didn't know whether to put her with the white or black contestants.
What I want people to take is we had challenges in this small southern town, but now that same Indian girl was elected as a 38-year-old Indian American female for the governor of the state of South Carolina. It says so much about South Carolina.
Her parents taught her can't is not an option. It became her personal motto and is the title of her new book that details her journey to the governor's mansion. She faced many obstacles, including what she calls the implosion of former Palmetto Governor Mark Sanford, the Republican sweetheart who fell from grace after going public about an extramarital affair with his Argentinian soulmate.
All of a sudden, I went from being the person that Sanford was going to endorse to the person who couldn't get anybody to return her phone calls.
Haley's parents practiced Sikhism. During her gubernatorial race, she was pressured to distance herself from them. It's something she wasn't willing to do. She says her Indian heritage helped prepare her for public service.
Indian families are very close. They believe strongly in work ethic. And more than anything, my mom always said, if you do something, make sure you're great at it. Make sure that people remember you for it.
Haley converted to Christianity after meeting her husband, Michael. She's only been governor for 14 months, but there's already speculation about what's next for the young Republican. Could she end up on the short list for vice president?
I'm not a planner. I've never been one that thinks too far ahead, because then you're disappointed. God has opened a lot of doors for me. And so I take it one step at a time and do the best I can. Then the next day I wake up and say, let's try this again.
And lots of people will be watching what she does. David, back to you at the sacred Lambeau Field.
Thanks, Jennifer. And by the way, we know you're a huge Green Bay Packers fan, so we will be bringing you back a cheesehead. It may not be the one on my head, but it will be a cheesehead, and it will be on the Brody File expense report.